From Nutrien Ag Solutions, this is Senior Meteorologist Andrew Pritchard with your Canadian Prairie weather story for Monday, May 10th, 2021. Looking at the hazards map here from across the prairie provinces, you see the gray shading in here. It's just a dense fog advisory, and that'll be expiring here as we head later into the morning hours. You can see the area of fog across southern Alberta. I'll highlight it in white there. As you look there, the satellite picture of the sun comes up. See the low-level cloudiness, and some of that, of course, is some dense fog down near the surface. And again, that will be burning off as we head through the later part of the day. Sunshine will be taking its place across much of the prairie. With all of that sunshine, the radar is clear as well. Precipitation has moved on out of the area, but it will be coming back in isolated to scattered fashion as we head through the week here. Almost daily chances for just widely isolated, widely scattered showers. This is the NAM model showing the forecast Monday through Thursday afternoon. And as you can see, we head through each day here. Just some little subtle upper-level disturbances, really disorganized opportunities again for mostly hit-or-miss light precipitation as we head through the week. Side by side, I've got the NAM on the left, the European model on the right. You can kind of make out higher chances for light precipitation in the west, lower chances in the east. So southern Manitoba, probably a better chance that we're dry. But even as you head across central and southern Alberta, where the chances for showers may be more higher coverage, that doesn't necessarily mean we're going to be looking at more in the way of, you know, soaking precipitation. This is going to be quite light. I think on the high end, we're looking at just kind of remoistening the top layer here, maybe a few millimeters of precipitation as we head through, head through the week here, the next 5 days. More in the way of heavier precipitation opportunities as we head into next week. And we'll take a look at those here in just a moment. Now, the jet stream pattern here as we get started on this Monday morning, May 10th, this is why we're looking at disorganized precipitation. We've got jet stream flow kind of coming through the U.S. We've also got an area of high pressure across the prairie provinces. So disorganized flow, not only that, but you can see it splitting here. This is called split flow. And when we see the flow doing that, we end up with drier conditions downstream there. So this is a dry pattern across the prairie. We're going to have just enough in the way of upper level lift to kick off some of those showers again as we head through the next few days, but nothing in the way of focused storm systems like we saw as we went through the weekend in the western half of the region. So we'll hit play on this, and this will take us through the next several days. And again, we watch this pattern, really disorganized jet stream flow across the prairie as we head through the middle part of the week. This is now Wednesday getting into Thursday, and then we'll take it toward the end here. This is going to get to the end of the week, Thursday night. And again, by the time we get to Thursday, much of the jet stream flow still going south of the prairie, but still the opportunity for some very light scattered precipitation as we head through the week here. We'll look at the precipitation forecast, and this again from the European model. We'll take a little bit deeper into next week, and you'll see the transition from, again, starting off this week, very light opportunities for precipitation. Here's, we'll take it a little bit slower here, but here's Monday, probably going to be dry for just about everyone except the Peace River in northern Alberta folks, maybe seeing some showers or some flurries today. We'll take it into Tuesday, and this is when we start to see those daily chances for some showers, first in Alberta, and then that'll spread into Saskatchewan as we get into Wednesday and Thursday. But you're not picking up on much in the way of focused precipitation here. It's just every day, every afternoon, we see those splotchy light greens show up, and that's the European model trying to pick up on those isolated showers, typically popping up here as we get into the afternoon and evening hours. Now, here's the transition. This is when we start to pivot from disorganized, light, hit-or-miss shower activity into much more focused storm system activity. As I go ahead and click off of the map, let's do this one more time. We'll bring it into the weekend. So here we go, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Now we get into Saturday. Here's the transition now. We're going to start to see more in the way of storm systems sweeping in from the west and from the southwest. So again, we're going to take it verbatim here, act like this is exactly how it's going to play out, though we know that it's not. The European model, no model can pick up on the exact details here a week out. But as we transition, this has been a consistent signal into the end of the weekend and early next week, a consistent signal of more in the way of focused storm systems sweeping through the Pacific Northwest, Western Canada, into the prairie provinces. So here's the upper level pattern here as we go through the next 10 days or so. We're looking at the 500 millibar height anomalies. We'll take this, we'll jump back, get going here. Monday, this is the pattern here. Remember, trough off to our south. We've got the ridge above us. That leads to disorganized flow across the region. Chances for showers as we head through midweek. This is the pattern as we get into Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. You're going to watch for a big trough to set up right there as we head into the early part of next week. May 15th and beyond, I think we're looking at a change in the pattern here across not just the Canadian Prairie, but all the way down into the plains and the Midwest of the United States. And so here it is, Days 0 to 5 on the left, days 5 to 10 on the right. Precipitation anomaly forecast. There are chances for precipitation here over the next 5 days. You saw them, but they are very light, very hit or miss. And so overall, drier compared to average. But as we transition into days 5 to 10, this is where the pattern change starts to occur. This is where I'm looking for more in the way of storm systems. Again, not just over the prairie, but all the way down into the northern plains of the United States. This is a very dry corridor, really, over the last couple of months. So you see the change there. Again, not just over the prairie provinces, but all the way down to the bottom of that graphic, through the Dakotas into Minnesota, Wisconsin, and the Corn Belt. Temperatures maybe leaning a little bit colder compared to average, but getting pretty close to average and steady is what it looks like over the next 5 to 10 days. It's going to get a little less uncertain as we get into, again, the end of the weekend into next week, when we're potentially bringing more in the way of storm systems into the region. But with disorganized, unfocused flow in the jet stream across the region, temperatures day to day going to be pretty steady across the region. And you can see that here. We'll look at Calgary warming up to the middle teens and mostly staying there midweek into the weekend. Very similar look here in Edmonton. You do see things maybe hinting at a cool down as we get to the end of the weekend into early next week, and that again is when that pattern change occurs. So we'll have to watch temperatures as we get on the other side of the weekend, but until then, pretty steady. Here's Regina, and then we'll finish up with Winnipeg, and then we'll finish up with a plug for the daily Canadian Prairie Weather Intelligence Report. As we head into a very crucial time frame across the region, as we start talking about planting and heading into the growing season, we start talking about finer details with some of these storm systems, bringing those crucial rain opportunities and thunderstorm chances and other sort of impactful weather to the region. There's only so much that we can do with a once a week video here on Monday. So the way that you're going to stay tuned is, if you haven't already, going to this website, info.nutrien.com/Pritchard_weather_CA. That's going to get you signed up for the Canadian Prairie Weather Intelligence Report. Anyone can sign up for that. And then Monday through Friday, typically mid to late morning, a little bit before the lunch hour, you're going to get an email, and it's going to have the details on the next couple of days. And then we'll have a fresh outlook on the next 5 to 10 days and beyond with each of these as well. So my point being, you'll want to stay in the loop this way, because we're going to have to each day watch some of the changes here, especially as we talk about the pattern change looming this weekend and into next week. Have a wonderful Monday and a great week. We'll talk to you again next Monday.